a manner that leads the audience to a clearly defined goal. The speech includes a beginning, a body, and a conclusion, major facts or ideas, and appropriate support material with smooth transitions between the facts and ideas. In addition to your verbal evaluation, please complete this evaluation while narrating the speech in each category and offering comments or specific recommendations. Did action by warranted. Back to you.
Thank you, Ms. Generator. Deven-Raja. The moments of my backpacking adventures. The moments of my backpacking adventures. Deven-Raja. My mentor, Mr. SKLU, the distinguished role players, and my fellow Toastmasters. I enjoy traveling, and traveling on backpacking or solo adventures to foreign countries intrigue me the most. And it is this intrigue that prompted me to travel to the to the wild jungles of Sri Lanka.
Oh. Wow.
And as you can see on the pictures printed on my t-shirt, my trip to Sri Lanka was pretty wild because it was filled with icebreaking, complete with communication and advanced communication moments. So this 7-minute chronological speech will be on my 8-day visit to Sri Lanka with an objective to share with all of you a breeze of those 8 days. The first 3 days were filled with ice-breaking moments as those 3 days offered me new and radical experiences such as the new language and food in Sri Lanka. On the first day, upon arriving in the Colombo International Airport, I immediately took a 12-hour bus ride right to Kataragama. Kataragama is a temple complex town which houses Hindu, Buddhist, Christian, and Muslim temples or places of worship. And in the morning of the second day, after visiting the Hindu Mahadevalaya temple complex in Kataragama, I immediately reframed my route of initially going to Kandy to the new route of going to Gali. So after a 5-hour journey, on the third day, I was totally enthralled to tread on the stone-cold steps of the Gale Fortress, which is a United Nations World Heritage Site. So after a few hours in Gale, I took a 5-hour train ride to Pinawali, the land of elephants. Now, turn to your partner, turn to the person sitting beside you and say, Deven enjoys traveling. Indeed, I do. So, on the 4th, 5th, and 6th days, were filled with competent communication moments, as most of my communication was with Mother Nature, such as with the jungles and mountains. So, on the morning of the 4th day, I went jungle trekking to the Pinawale Elephant Park. I was pleasantly surprised to see the elephants roaming free in there. I even had an elephant ride there. So after a few more hours, I left on a tuk-tuk taxi ride, a 4-hour tuk-tuk taxi ride to Kandy. As you can see on the map here, Kandy is a city which a Sri Lankan city which houses the Buddhist temple of Lord Buddha's tooth relic. So in the morning of the 5th day, I visited the temple and had a religious competent communication moment there. And after a short visit to the flourish botanical gardens in Kandy, I took a 5-hour tuk-tuk taxi ride to Adam's Peak, the Dalhousie actually, which is a tea plantation village at the foot of Mount Adam, which is one of the tallest mountains in Sri Lanka. And after checking into one of the nearby guest houses in Dalhousie, I immediately went trekking along the trail leading to the peak of Mount Adam, or in other words, better known as Adam's Peak. The trail was freakishly dark and shiveringly cold. That called for a moment of competent communication moment with the nature, with the mountains there. And at that moment, I heard a tune in my head. Reframe your mind. And after taking 1,000 steps, I finally reached the peak of Mount Adam, Adam's Peak. Oh, whoo, it was freezing cold. It was freezingly cold. I was so cold. So after catching the sunrise view in Mount Adam, I slowly but gradually descended from Mount Adam due to the severe leg cramps that was killing me. So after staggering into the guest house in Dalhousie, I immediately took a hot water shower. Now turn to the person sitting beside you, and ask, why not a cold water shower?
A cold water shower
after such a freezing experience? Ew! That would have actually worsened the situation of the condition of my cramped legs. So after taking a short nap in the guest house, I immediately went on a 7-hour train ride to Anuradhapura, which houses yet another United Nations World Heritage Site, the historical city of Anuradhapura. So the 7 and 8 days, positively, the 7 to 8 days were filled with advanced communication moments, my communication on those days was mainly with my heart and soul to persevere in successfully completing this amazing race visit to the wild jungles of Sri Lanka. And on the wee hours of the morning of the seventh day, once I arrived in Anuradhapura, I immediately took a tuk-tuk taxi ride and hired the driver to take me on a short tour to the United Nations World Heritage Site in Anuradhapura, and also including the site of the oldest tree in the world. Now turn to the person sitting beside you, and ask, how old is the tree? Well, it must be quite old, because that's the exact oak tree that Lord Buddha sat under when he experienced these divine revelations. So after a few hours in Anuradhapura, I immediately took a 5-hour bus ride back to Colombo. And on the 8th day, the morning of the 8th day, I joyfully headed to the Colombo International Airport to board a flight back to Malaysia. But with an advanced communication question in my head. Now turn to a person sitting beside you and ask, what's the question? Why haven't I found my dream girl yet? Well, that's because Deven had a great and wild time in Sri Lanka, because it was filled with ice breaking, competent communication and advanced communication modes. Thank you.